Today, we're going to talk about humanity's journey back to the moon. NASA's Artemis II mission is bringing us one step closer to the lunar surface. And the biggest question, is this the beginning of our journey to Mars? Together, we'll explore all the answers. Let's get started. NASA's 2025 moon mission. What to expect from Artemis II? Introduction. Humanity is preparing to make history on its journey back to the moon. After more than 50 years, NASA is officially returning to the moon with the Artemis program. The Artemis II mission, set for 2025, will be the final major test before sending humans to the lunar surface again. In this mission, astronauts will complete a round trip around the moon, paving the way for future crewed landings. But what can we expect from this historic mission? Why is it important? Who are the astronauts? How does the technology work? Here are all the details. NASA successfully launched the first uncrewed mission of the Artemis program in 2022. And with the Artemis II mission in 2025, it aims to restart human missions to the moon. While one of the main objectives may seem to be establishing a permanent base on the moon, the ultimate goal is even bigger. A look back, Apollo 11's historic lunar landing. In this blog, we will revisit the most memorable moments of the 1969 Apollo 11 moon landing and dream of a future where human settlements on the moon can be seen with the naked eye from Earth. On July 20th, 1969, at the Houston Mission Control Center, Apollo 11 lunar module pilot Buzz Aldrin's voice echoed, "Last 5%, Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin were only 30 meters above the lunar surface, but they had only 5% of their fuel remaining." Buzz Aldrin checked the instruments once more and called out to Neil Armstrong, 22 feet. The Eagle lunar module, carrying two astronauts, descended into a cloud of lunar dust, almost as if it were being reborn. At the 103rd hour of the mission, Neil Armstrong's words broke the silence of space. "Houston, Tranquility Base here. The Eagle has landed." About 2 hours later, the first human footprint was left on the moon, as Armstrong declared, "That's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind." Now, 55 years later, humanity is preparing for another lunar adventure with the same excitement and ambition that once launched the Saturn V rocket. This time, a new rocket, the Space Launch System, SLS, is being prepared to take humans back to the moon. But this time, it's not just a visit. The goal is to establish a permanent presence. Artemis I, a successful test flight. In recent months, NASA successfully completed the uncrewed Artemis I mission. The Orion spacecraft completed its historic journey around the moon and safely landed in the Pacific Ocean. The journey to the moon wasn't easy, and neither was the return. Upon re-entry, the Orion capsule reached a speed of 24,500 miles per hour, causing its heat shield to experience extreme temperatures of 5,000 degrees Fahrenheit. The spacecraft spent 25.5 days in space, covering 1.4 million miles, 2.25 million kilometers. NASA also tested a new planetary entry technique during Orion's landing. This technique, which NASA compares to skipping a stone across a river, allows a spacecraft to maneuver by performing a small bounce off the upper atmosphere. With Orion now safely back, NASA is analyzing sensor data from the mannequins on board to prepare for future crewed missions. Artemis II, the next step in lunar exploration. On April 3rd, 2023, NASA announced the crew for the Artemis II mission. The four astronauts are Christina Hammock, Koch, Mission Specialist, Jeremy Hansen, Mission Specialist, Victor Glover, Pilot, Reed Wiseman, Commander. The crew will launch from Launch Complex 39B at NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida for a 10-day mission aboard the Orion spacecraft, powered by NASA's massive SLS rocket. For the first 2 days, they will test Orion's systems and conduct a targeting test near Earth before heading toward the Moon. Orion's European Space Agency-built service module will provide the powerful thrust needed to escape Earth's orbit and begin the lunar journey. This translunar injection burn will send the astronauts on a 4-day journey to the Moon, where they will travel beyond the far side of the Moon, forming a figure-8 trajectory extending more than 230,000 miles, 370,000 kilometers from Earth. At their farthest point, they will be about 6,400 miles, 10,000 kilometers beyond the Moon. During their 4-day return trip, the astronauts will continue evaluating the spacecraft's systems. Finally, the crew will endure high-speed, high-temperature re-entry into Earth's atmosphere before splashing down in the Pacific Ocean near San Diego, where they will be recovered by NASA and the Department of Defense. Artemis III and beyond, a permanent lunar presence. NASA's next step, Artemis III, aims to land humans on the Moon again. However, this mission is expected to take place in 2025 or 2026 at the earliest. While the primary objective seems to be establishing a permanent lunar base, the ultimate goal is much more ambitious. Launching a rocket from Earth requires enormous amounts of fuel to escape Earth's strong gravitational pull. According to Newton's third law of motion, a rocket's thrust must be significantly greater than its weight to lift off. This fuel requirement will be even more critical for human missions to Mars. But what if rockets could launch from a place with weaker gravity? The Moon's gravity is 6 times weaker than Earth's, meaning that significantly less fuel would be needed to launch from the lunar surface. This is why NASA is planning a permanent moon base that could serve as a launch point for missions to Mars and beyond. The first woman on the Moon. If these missions are successful, NASA will achieve another historic milestone, sending the first woman to walk on the Moon. Between 1969 and 1972, 12 astronauts walked on the Moon, all of them men. But this time, NASA is preparing for a more diverse crew as part of the Artemis program. Is NASA the only one working on lunar and Mars missions? NASA isn't the only space agency making progress toward the Moon and Mars. Other countries and private companies are also advancing their own space programs. Some have already taken major steps forward. So far, only 3 countries have successfully landed a spacecraft on the Moon: United States, Russia, formerly the Soviet Union, China. However, only the United States has sent humans to the Moon. But other nations are rapidly developing their own lunar and Mars programs. China, for example, has become a leader in space exploration. With its own Tiangong space station, China is making significant progress in lunar and Martian exploration. As all these efforts continue, one question remains: how will the Moon look after these missions? Will future launches from the Moon be visible with a telescope from Earth? Instead of traveling to a launch site on Earth, will we be able to watch moon-based launches from our own backyards? We can only wait with excitement and curiosity to find out. Conclusion: Artemis II will be one of the most important steps in humanity's deep space exploration. Returning to the Moon will create new opportunities for astronauts and scientists. But the ultimate goal is even bigger, Mars. Do you think the Artemis II mission will be successful? Will humanity make it to Mars in the near future? Share your thoughts in the comments. For more space exploration and science updates, don't forget to subscribe to our channel.